Hey guys, welcome to this video on number place values. I understand that numbers can be confusing sometimes, so I'm going to do the best that I can to help you guys understand. Let's take a look at a couple of different numbers. These numbers seem easy enough. You have 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, and 1 million. If you look closely, you can see that if you multiply each number by 10, you get the number to the left. So 1 times 10 is 10, 10 times 10 is 100, and 100 times 10 is 1,000, and so on. In any number, the same is true. The digit to the left has a place value 10 times the place to its right. Let's try adding all these numbers together and see what number we get. You get 1,111,111. We can see how this place value increases by 10 times as you move to the left. Let's try another. Find the place value of 8 in 9,865. Now, if we rewrite this, we can make this a little easier to visualize. 9,000 plus 800 plus 60 plus 5. So this is 9,000s plus 800s plus 610s plus 5 ones. So let's look back at our problem. Find the place value of 8 in 9,865. So we're looking for the place value of the 8 in our number here. When we write it out, we can clearly see that 8 is in the hundreds place. Now try one on your own. In the following numbers, the digit 6 represents a value of 1,000 in which number? A, 67,419, B, 236,798, and C, 1,624. Let's start with A. I'm going to expand it so we can see it more clearly. 60,000 plus 7,000 plus 400 plus 10 plus 9, or 6 10,000s, 7,000s, 400s, 1 10, and 9 1s. Now, we are able to see that in choice A, there is a 7 in the thousands place. So, let's move on to choice B, 236,798. As you get more and more familiar with finding place values, it will become second nature, but for now, we'll continue to expand our numbers. So we have 200,000 plus 30,000 plus 6,000 plus 700 plus 90 plus 8, or 200,000s plus 310,000s plus 6,000s plus 700s plus 910s plus 8 ones. Now let's look back and see what our problem was asking for. The digit 6 in which number represents a value of 1,000? Well, we can see that we have a 6 in the thousands place, so B is our answer. Great work, guys. If rewriting and expanding the number is not a helpful method for you, then let's try one more thing. When you have a whole number and there are no digits to the right, you know that you're dealing with a number in the ones place, like 7. When there is one other digit to the right, then you are in the tens place, like 70. When there are two digits to the right, then you are in the hundreds place, like 700. If there are three digits to the right, then you are in the thousands place, like 7,000. If there are four, then you are in the 10,000s place, like 70,000. If there are five, you are in the 100,000s place. If there are six, you are in the millions place, and so on. Practice finding place values on your own by making your own whole numbers and writing the place value for each of the digits. So far, we've only looked at whole numbers. So let's take a look at decimal numbers. 4,367.521. Remember, every digit to the left of the decimal is a whole number, and every digit to the right is a fraction or decimal number. Since we already know how to identify place values for whole numbers, for now, let's look at everything to the right of the decimal. So we have our decimal point, then 521. Let's simplify. We have 5 over 10 plus 2 over 100 plus 1 over 1,000, or 5 tenths plus 2 hundredths plus 1 thousandths. The digit to the very right of the decimal represents the 10 place value. The second digit to the right of the decimal represents the hundredths place value, and so on. One important thing to note is that there is not a 1th place. There is only a 1's place, because 1 over 1 is equal to 1, and 1 is a whole number. I hope this video has helped you better understand number place values. Be sure to practice on your own until you feel confident in your ability to correctly identify place values. Check out more of our videos by subscribing below. See you next time.